Hey guys, your Nate from Melvin Flint here. Hope you look good, feel good and are ready to prosper, because in this video I'd like to talk about how to take control of your emotions and become the cold-hearted person you desire to be. And yes, I know you guys love these videos, and therefore if you're someone that is new to this channel and would love to see more videos like this, please consider to hit the subscribe button and help your brother out, because we're very close to 10k subscribers, and therefore by you subscribing you really help the channel out. Anyways, with that said, let's jump into the video. So if you're someone that wants to be a cold-hearted person, someone that just simply doesn't care that much about other individuals, it's very crucial that you're able to take control of your emotions and put yourself in a position where you're on some more rational than irrational caused by emotions. And thus, the first thing that is very important is to understand yourself. You know, everyone's different. Some individuals are extremely sensitive, while other individuals just simply don't care and do whatever they want, even when everyone is hating. And that's why it's so important to understand what kind of individual you are. Are you someone that is extremely sensitive and the opinion of others affect your emotions, or are you someone that doesn't care that much? And understanding and analyzing this is very important, because this way you can evaluate where you currently are and what kind of steps you have to take to get yourself to a level where you can control your emotions. Number two, recognize your situation. So alright, now you understand what kind of person you are. And so, for example, if you're someone that's extremely sensitive and you are in an environment that has a huge impact on your emotions, you need to recognize that this might be the cause of it. And unfortunately, when it comes to love situations, we can't really control everything, while understanding and controlling yourself is much easier, because a lot of times it's quite hard to influence other individuals to actually make them change. And thus, sometimes it's better to leave them behind and get yourself in a different situation. And what I mean by this is to sometimes get yourself a new friend circle, start to hang out less with those individuals, or perhaps in extreme situations change your whole environment. Another thing that you may want to do is to start changing yourself, because the reality is there are bad people out there, and if you're someone that looks vulnerable, they might want to take advantage of it. And thus, if you're someone that wants to take control of your emotions, sometimes it's best to start to take control over yourself. Start to dress better, start to take care of yourself, perhaps hit the gym, because this way you change the way you look, and therefore you change the way those other individuals perceive you. So unfortunately, you can't always change your situation, but you can change how those people in that particular situation perceive you. Number three, identify how you're feeling. You know, when it comes to emotions, a lot of times it's quite irrational, but we can always find some sort of reason behind it as to why we're feeling a certain way, even if it doesn't make sense. Because we as humans can start to feel emotional for the strangest reasons, and there's nothing wrong with that. That's just the way we are. And thus, you don't have to beat up yourself for it. But the reason to identify why you're feeling a certain way is important, because this way you can start to elevate as to why you're feeling this way. And the next time, if you're in a similar situation, you might be able to take more control of your emotions, because you can look back at the previous experiences and start to analyze what kind of steps you took to overcome this burden. And yes, I know it might hurt sometimes, but this brings me to number four, accept your reality. So the thing about taking control of your emotions is that you need to accept the reality. I know it hurts sometimes, and a lot of times we try to put ourselves in the victim role, because this makes us feel better about ourselves. And although this tends to help us in the short term, it doesn't have very good long-term benefit, because if you put yourself in the victim role and think you can't do much about it, you won't be able to process and take steps to get out of this rut hole. Well, when it comes to accepting the reality, you understand that you're not in a perfect position and you need to take measurements to get out of it. And although that takes courage, in the long term, you will definitely thank yourself. And you know, putting yourself in a victim role is one side of the spectrum, but what about the other side of the spectrum? Should we put ourselves in that position? In my opinion, the answer is no. And this brings me to number five. Give yourself some space. You know, there's no point to put yourself in a victim role, but at the same time, there's no point to blame everything on yourself, because the truth is, it's a mixture of both. A lot of times it's the way you perceive things and how external factors have influenced your situation and the way you're currently feeling. And thus, it's very important to give yourself some space. You don't have to blame everything on yourself, but at the same time, don't try to blame everything on others. And yes, I know, some of you guys will say, I've already done all of those steps, so what do you suggest me to do then, Junaid? Well, that brings me to number six, change your environment. You know, sometimes it's hard. We've tried everything. We're trying to actually make the best of the situation, but it's not working. You feel a lot of emotions. You've tried a lot of things. What's left to do? Well, in that particular case, time is your friend. Because a lot of times, time is the thing that allows us to heal and allow us to prosper later in life. And thus, in that particular situation, I would put a pause on it and try to change your environment. Because you don't constantly want to be in this negative environment. And thus, by you changing this environment, You give yourself more time and allow time to heal this particular situation. And after you change your environment and allow time to heal yourself, it's time for a different you when you come back. And this brings me to number 7, transform you. Because let's face it, it's probably not the first time that you felt like you couldn't take control of your emotions. And thus, there's no point of letting time heal it, knowing that in the future, you might make the same mistake again. And even if you don't go back to your previous environment, you're still the same person. Maybe you've learned a few things, but you haven't transformed yet. And thus, that's why it's very important to start to take care of yourself, of your financials, of the way you look. Start to work hard, go to the gym, and become a person you're proud of. Because the more proud you are of yourself, the more comfortable you feel in your skin. And therefore, you'll feel like that you have more control of the situation, and thus you can take control of your emotions. Because I know you want to prosper, I want you to prosper, but the thing is, you need to put in the work. You need to transform yourself and become a better version of yourself that you are proud of. And you know, that pretty much sums it up for this video. I hope you found the information useful. If you did, please let me know in the comments down below. And also, please consider to hit the subscribe button if you're new to this channel, because I love making videos like this. And I know that these videos genuinely help you out, and I want you to succeed. And therefore, if you can also consider to leave a thumbs up for the YouTube algorithm, that will be appreciated. Anyways, thanks so much for watching. I hope you have a great day, and I hope to see you on my next video. Bye bye.